This is Enderman, and this is the model that I taught last week here. And while I was teaching it, I needed a Minecraft pointer tool for one of the steps, and I ended up designing this whole new model. This is the Eye of the Dragon Switchblade Sword. And I'm now going to show you how to fold it. Ready, set, here goes. Whoosh. So for this Dragon Eye Switchblade Sword, whose crossguard can also be folded into dragon wings, which I'll show how to do in a special video for my members only, I folded it from a 6-inch square of kami, and that's what I'm going to use for this tutorial. But instead of red, I'm going to use a sheet of blue so that it's easier to see. So begin white side up, or blade side up, and fold diagonally in half. Try to make really precise folds, and crease sharply. Unfold, turn over, and fold in half diagonally in this direction. Now rotate and fold this front flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge, but only fold from the corner to the crease. And unfold and repeat on this side. Unfold and pinch the corner and make both creases at the same time, and collapse to the right, and there we have a rabbit ear. And now turn over and repeat on this side. And collapse to the right. So it's like that. Now fold this flap over so that this length between these two points is equal to this length between these two points. You don't need to crease sharply here. So it's like that. And now turn over and repeat on this side. And you can also line up with these two points on the back. So you have thirds. And just softly crease that and rotate. And now fold this front flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And fold to this point. And turn over and repeat. Now unfold this flap and this flap, and fold the front flap so that this bottom edge aligns with the top edge. Try to hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And turn over and repeat on this side. Now careful that you line up with this edge. You want this point and this point to touch. And same on this side. That's your guide. And crease it all nice and sharp. And now unfold this flap and this flap, and unfold the rabbit ear. Just on this side. So here we have a street map. We're going to fold on this outer triangle of creases. So, go like this, and like this, and like this. Okay, now turn over, and now we're going to fold on this inner triangle of creases. So, go like this. If you want, you can do it from the other side. That way you can pinch along the inner triangle. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Pinch, pinch, pinch. Pinch, pinch, pinch. And flatten. So this is the pleat sinking. That's what it looks like on this side. And this is what it looks like on this side. And turn over and repeat on this side. And make those flaps go back and forth, and make them go to the same side. Now open right there, Turn over and fold this flap so that this edge aligns with the middle crease, but don't fold sharply, just loosely there, like that. And now open here, lift this layer out, and pinch along the existing crease, like that, and flatten. And repeat on this side. So you don't need to crease it very much at all. You just go like that, lift it out, make this existing crease, and flatten. And here we have the cross guard. Now, if you're using printer paper or just paper that's not white on one side, paper that's not two colors, you might want to just leave it like this because this is clean on this side and clean on that side. But if you want to do the color change, I'm going to show you how to do that. So what you want to do is open this front layer and you're going to fold it behind. But what about here? Well, that needs to get turned inside out, and it helps if you just open it just enough so that you can push this point through. Like that. And once it's through, now you can continue folding this behind. I'm going to turn over so you see what's happening on this side. And it flattens like this. And the color change is complete on this side. Now do the same thing on this side. So open here and fold this edge behind. Open it a little bit so that you can push this in and fold it behind and squash it. And you might want to just kind of push these layers together so that the line isn't as noticeable. Turn back over and you can flatten this out, sharpen your knife. And now let's work on the handle. So fold this up between these two points. Crease sharply and unfold. And now open here and bring the flap up like this and bring these raw edges together and flatten. So it's like this. And fold it to this side and that side. Okay, and make it stick up. Open the pocket and squash it. But instead of squashing it evenly, we're going to squash it so that this fold aligns with this edge. So it's a right triangle, like that. And repeat on this side. So there we have a nice square. And you might like it just like that. But if you want to make the square inside the square, the dragon eye, then this is what to do. Rotate and fold this flap up. How far? Now this is a tricky little guideline. Zoom in. Oh, not so much. Okay, so what we want to aim for is we want the length from this point to this edge, in other words, this length, to be equal to the length from this point to this edge, in other words, right here. So you want those two lengths to be the same. And just eyeball it, dragon eyeball it, and it's like that. Crease that sharply, and now unfold. Open here, and fold along that middle crease. And now, like we did before, bring these two edges together and these two edges together and flatten. So we just sunk the point and now fold this flap out to this side and like that. So we have a similar shape. And now just simply fold this flap down like this. And there we have the square inside the square, the dragon eye handle. And you might want to just kind of try to make things line up a little bit better if they don't already. All right, so there it is. All right, so if you like it like this, you're done, but I'm going to show you how to do this magic trick. So you have it folded in half like this. There should already be a crease there, and unfold it. Now, fold the blade behind, right on this line, and now It's like this. Just fold the handle in half and it comes back up. Again, you just hold it like this and it comes back up. And the idea is that you want to try to hide the blade behind the cross guard so that the audience doesn't see it. Like that. Or alternatively, you could hold it with your fingers like that so that it can go a little bit further back. And then like that. So from the side, I am holding it with that finger and press, it comes up. So there you have it. And it also spins sort of. You can just kind of bend it so that it spins a little bit easier. And for the dragon wing cross guard, I have a separate video for my members only, but honestly, it's really just like my dragon wings, which you can find in this tutorial. All right, so if you like it like this, then you're done. But if you want to add these couple folds here so that it looks a little bit more intricate and it closes it up a little bit better, then this is what to do. Open this layer, pull it out, and make a fold that goes from this point to this point. And squash. So it's like that. And now take this flap and fold it into this pocket. Like that. And repeat. And you see it just closes the white up a little bit better. And the other nice thing about this is that this could be a greeting card. Just put two arrows on the cross guard that say, pull out. And now, when you pull open those points, you can write a secret letter. Or you could just fold them behind like this. And write. Ooh, it looks kind of like a bird here. Just make sure that you write below these two points. I'm your sword a guy who likes to slay really bad puns. Watch out. And this sordid, punny note that I wrote on the model we made still opened, phew, like a switchblade. And just before another pun, oh lord, it flew up like a rocket. And it soared. Sorry, it sort of got carried away. All right, so there you have it. Hope you guys enjoyed folding this model, and sorry for piercing you with all the bad puns. And if you had a problem with it, well, we'll sort it out later. And I'll catch you later.